Hey YouTube, welcome to another video. In this episode, I will do an unboxing of a TP Link Omada switch that I believe is a very good entry level loyalty switch. So this switch is the SG2008 switch. It offers 8 gigabit ports and it can be powered either via the 12 volt 1 amp DC power or through PoE via port 8, and it supports 802.380/AF standard for PoE. As a standalone, this is an awesome managed switch. It can be just a port extender that doesn't strip VLANs, and for its price, it can also act as a dedicated DHCP server that supports multi-pool configuration, which is really pretty useful in a pinch. This switch is also part of the Omada family, and this means it can be adapted into the platform, making configuration a breeze. Other features of this switch includes IGMP snooping, 802.1Q support, QoS, static lag, ACLs, 802.1X, LACP, and jumbo frame. It has 32 MB of flash and 256 MB of DRAM, as well as 16 gigabits per second of switching capacity. But for me, the most interesting capability of this switch, looking at its price and performance, is that it also offers 16 IP interfaces and can also do switch static routing. And it's doing all of that for just 6.4 watts of maximum power consumption. And to put that into perspective, it is much less consumption than Pi 5 at 12 watts and even compared to Pi 4 at 8 watts. So let me just switch to the device information. In Amazon, you can see that this device goes for $74.99, so it's $75. I believe I have the version 3 of this device as well, which is what they are selling currently at Amazon. Personally, I have used this device for quite some time now, but it's a much earlier version and it's doing layer 2 switching for my homeland. And this is the specifications that you will find in the TP-Link. I did go through that in the intro, but you can see here it's 12 volt DC 1 amp external powered adapter or through PoE, 6.4 watts of maximum power consumption, and this is the backplane speed, which is 16 gigabits per second. Standard feature for Omada managed switch devices, static routing with 16 IP interfaces. So this is pretty good for both IPv4 and IPv6. Support standard spanning tree protocol and all the goodies for a managed switch. Okay, so I'll leave the link into the description for both the Amazon link and the TP-Link official site. For this unboxing, I will be showing a simple deployment of this device as a layer 2 switch. As you can see in this diagram, I have it set up as a LAN router doing layer 2 switching with 3 access switches. I have defined VLAN 11 to VLAN 91, and all of them are SBIs and have DHCP server on each SBIs. I also have a pair of ports for a total of 2 gigabits per second uplink for each of the access switches as a starter. But this device can bundle more than 2 ports for LACP. For the configuration walkthrough, just a reminder, I'll go through a lot of this very quickly because I have covered a lot of this in my previous videos. I will only go slowly for those parts that are quite new for this video, but for most of the time, I'll just quickly speed up to the video so that you can quickly go through the meat of the video. Okay, so these are the devices that I have. I have the ER605, I have the SG2008, and this is my layer 2 switch in the topic of this unboxing. And I have all the other switches in here as my access switches. You can see here, I have SG3428, SG3428X, and SG2210MP. But only the SG2008 is a layer 2 switch in this video. So these are their model and their firmware versions. So for the SG2008, like I mentioned, this is where all the SBIs are currently defined, as well as all the DHCP server configuration. And you can see this is where I have it configured. I will just go through each and every SBI in here quickly. So I will speed up the video. As for the port configuration, as I have mentioned, I have configured three pairs of the ports for this switch as LAG. As you can see here, I have three groups of LAG. So lag 1 is port 7 and 8, lag 2 is ports 5 and 6, and lag 3 is ports 3 and 4. So ports 3 and 4 is connected to SG3428, ports 5 and 6 are connected to SG3428X, and ports 7 and 8 are connected to SG2210MP. So let me show you where the cabling is connected. So let me just show up my mini screen here. If you're looking at the mini screen, so this pair of cables are connected to SG3428. Another pair is connected to SG3428X, and another pair is connected to SG2210MP. For the SG3428X and SG3428, I'm using only the top port so that it's easy for me to plug in and plug the cables. So for the SG3428, you can see that there is no SVI defined in here. And for the ports, you can see that ports 1 and 3 are configured for LAG. LAG 1. And you can see that caret signifying both of them are uplinks and none of them are blocking. So I have two GBPS uplink to the layer 2 switch. So for the SG3428X, again, no SVI is configured in this switch. As for the ports, very similar story with the SG3428. I have both ports 1 and 3 configured as LACP, lag 1 in here. As you can see, both of them are showing a caret, meaning both of them are uplinks to the SG3428. So I have 2 gigabits per second uplink. And last but not the least, I have the SG2210MP. I don't have any SPI configured in the switch. As for the ports, you can see that I have both ports 1 and port 2 configured for LAG. So for the VLAN configuration, this is how my wired networks are configured. I only have one gateway VLAN interface, which is the admin VLAN, and all the others are just layer 2 broadcast only VLANs. All of them have the same configuration, and I have shown this in the previous videos. I will just go through this very quickly. If you would like to know more about the configuration for this and why I have this configured like this, I highly recommend you watch the previous videos. I really don't have any custom profile for this network because I'm using profile all for all of the trunk uplinks. For the network security, I don't really have any active ACLs. I do have ACLs in here, but those are for other lab purposes and I currently have them all turned off. They are all turned off. And they are all turned off. So for static route, since I'm only using one layer to switch, I only have one static routing entry for my gateway. This is the IP address of the SG2008.192.168.101.100, since all of the SVIs are defined in that layer to switch. For the clients, you can see here that I have one host per layer to switch VLAN. So from VLAN 11 up to the 91, I have a .2 host in each. For the admin VLAN, this is where my PC is currently connected. I have another one, which is the Samsung PC, which is my laptop, but this is my PC. Okay, so I'm just going back to the devices in here just to show that the SG2008 is the one that's having an IP address of 192.168.101.100, which is used for gateway static routing. Before I do the demo, let me just show you my IP address. So my IP address is 192.168.101.105. I am in the admin VLAN. I am in the same IP network. Close. And I have here a batch file that goes through each of the SBIs and ping them all. It's called pinger point bat. So pinger will just ping all of the SVI, so all of the .1. I have another batch file that pings all the clients as well, but this one loops, so I will have to do a control break before it loops back again. So I call it ping loop. It will ping all the dat2s, all the clients. So let me do a control C and break that batch file. But as you can see, it has gone through all the host devices. And finally, and last but not the least, I will do a trace route commands for all of the SPI. So I have here a batch file that do just that. So I think that's pretty much it for this video. I just want to share this amazing device, the SG2008. Like I said, this is a pretty good entry-level layer 3 switch for an Omada platform. It can do a lot of the great things that a managed Omada switch can do for a very affordable price of $75. Thank you again for watching my video. If you like this video, please give it a like. If you don't like this video, please give it a dislike. But do let me know what you don't like so that I can further improve the future videos. Thank you for watching my videos. I'll see you again in the next one. Thank you and bye bye.